Hello there, good morning. Joining us today from Mining Capital is our Alastair Ford. Hello to you, Alastair. How are you?
Hello, Katie. I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. Now, we both had the pleasure of speaking to Bill Hooley this week from Anglesey Mining. It's a fantastic story, isn't it, this one?
Good British story. British jobs, British asset, British company. And it's great to see the story catching fire again and coming back to life. It's been quite a long time in the making, as Bill Hooley would be the first to admit. But now they've put out a preliminary economic study for the Parys Mountain copper project. Things are looking pretty positive, I think. I mean, the backdrop, as you know, is that the commodities markets have been doing well. Price of copper is high, price of other commodities that are in the ground at Parys there are doing relatively well too. So there's a good overall strength in the market. And the economic study that's been done shows three different options for development. Lower capex equaling lower return, as you might expect. But nonetheless, all the numbers look good. And on probably what's the best case scenario, the slightly higher capex spend there, you're looking at a $1 billion project on some metrics. So I think that is, as you say, a very positive development, and it'll be interesting to see what they do now, how they take the project forward from this stage.
Yeah, and it's a 12-year mine life. I know that much of the hard work is going to be done in the next 2 years or so to get it all on track and ready for operations. And Bill was telling me that it could mean from 120 to 150 jobs for people in and around that area, which I just think is fantastic. And also, I think it's interesting that we're talking about quite a few metals here, aren't we? Copper, zinc, lead, gold, silver, fingers in a lot of pies.
Well, the employment aspect is obviously very significant for local areas anywhere in the world. When a mining project comes to town, there's always the direct jobs that are created working on the mine and in the plants and the processing. But the ripple effects out into the wider local economies are huge. The idea that there will be wage earners, for a start, they can spend in the local economy, but there's also the sort of supplementary industries that sort of come on the back of a business like that, like catering companies and other forms of suppliers, uniform makers, equipment manufacturers, taxi drivers, you know, to drive people to work, or bus, you know, the effects are manifold. And it's an interesting factor in looking at Scott Gold, which is a company you and I have talked about in the past. When the planning permission was in dispute for Scott Gold's mine in Scotland, and people were against it being built because it's in a national park, what was very telling was that the local community, the immediate community to the mine, was very much in favour of developing that mine for the very reasons which you speak about, the local employment opportunities. So I think the idea that the mining is bad for the communities that are around it is a complex and nuanced argument. It's not simply a clear-cut case of ESG. So when you're creating jobs and you're mining properly and you're cleaning up after yourself, it can actually be a net positive. No question about it.
Absolutely. And it's very interesting when you talk about, we're not just thinking of miners here, we're thinking about the taxes, the hospitality, the catering, as you say. So it's that real multiplier effect. Well, great talking to you, Alastair, as always. It's always nice as well to feel like you're at the beginning of someone's story here, which with Anglesey, I know they've been around for a very long time, but with this Parys Mountain in particular, it's always rather exciting and great to be.
Well, maybe this is the end of the beginning, you know, as Churchill famously said.
That's it. Alastair Ford from Mining Capital, thank you very much.
Thanks, Katie.